Okay, good morning children. So today we will study about excretion in human beings. See, it is a process which is very important for the life for all of us. Okay, as you studied yesterday that there is a removal of liquid waste and the purification, like if you take heart as an example. So in that heart, there is one related organ called lungs. So lungs help in purification of blood. Okay, same way, like gases, carbon dioxide is one of the gaseous waste. So that is released through photosynthesis or through respiration. Same way, there are some liquid waste generated in our body. And especially in case of higher organism, we have these organs and organ system. But in lower animals, the body waste is removed through a process of diffusion or osmosis, because it is very simple. From one layer to other layer, they pass through their cells only. Like especially unicellular organisms, they will pass through their cells to the surroundings. But in the highly developed, there are some specialized organisms where their work is to remove the nitrogenous waste generated in the body along with blood. Okay, so how does excretion, actually what is excretion? So the process of removal of waste release in our body and removal of that waste is called excretion, excrete, removal. Okay, so the main important organs of removal of nitrogenous waste, especially solids, is nothing. It is faces, or solid waste is released out in the form of faces through anus and all. Okay, so liquid waste which is present in our body, especially our blood also contains, and these all liquid waste is removed by the help of kidneys, and even some of the part of the liquid waste is removed through the skin as excretory system. Okay, in the form of sweat. So how does the kidney work? Actually, why are our kidneys? What is the kidney? Why it is important? Okay. So we have kidneys, two kidneys, left kidney, right kidney. Okay, these kidneys are present at our abdomen, behind the nearby the backbone. Okay. So there are two pairs of kidneys. A pair of kidney, a pair of ureter, and there is a bladder called urinary bladder and urethra. That uterus is there, that uterus, I told left ureter, right ureter. So they all will help for the removal of nitrogenous waste, because these all, you know, I told aorta veins, these are aorta, these are veins, renal veins, these all will are supply, are the actually the nerves are coming from the other parts of the body and which bring out liquid waste. They are urea and uric acid. They are in the form of urea and uric acid. So nitrogenous waste will contain urea, uric acid mainly, and there are many other waste along with water, which is also little water is also waste. Okay. So these all are removed by the help of an organ called kidney. Okay, so but inside kidney, what is the process, what they contain, because generally I told blood comes from the impure blood comes from upper part through these aorta veins, and that will go to the kidneys, and inside what happens we don't know. Inside all the nitrogen waste, actually there is reabsorption taking place. Reabsorption means like sucrose, salts, many amino acids which are required for the body. Again, what it does, it will filter and send it back. The filtrate remaining is sent in the form of, again it is filtered in the form of urine. So there is a long process there. In this kidney, there are many millions of nephrons, nearly 1 to 1.5 million nephrons are there, 1.5 million
nephrons. Okay. So like lungs are the filtering organs, that in same way in the inside the kidney there are 1.5 million wire-like structures called nephrons. They are filtering units where they filter, where they reabsorb the process take place, and lastly they will throw out liquid which is called urine, in the form of urine. Okay, so these all are made, especially when the urine is generated here, when the reabsorption take place, and the whatever the useful material it will go back, and whatever the waste it will come through the ureter and it passes through the urinary bladder. So this bladder is a muscular part, muscular, made of muscles, muscular or elastic muscles will be there. So that has capacity of elasticity. Just if it is, if it increases inside, there the liquid, nothing, it is urine is stored there. It stores urine. Because urine, the urinary reaction is sometimes voluntary. So whenever we are controlling the urine water, this bag is not filled. So still we are not able to urinate. So that's why this bladder is made up of muscular layer. So afterwards, after some time when it fills up, that actually it should be removed out, and that is passed through urethra in the form of urine. It is thrown out. Okay. So this is how it will take place. But actually, inside what we have here, what is present in the nephron? What is the present in the kidney? We'll see it. Okay.
Okay, see children, so the basic filtration unit in the kidney, okay, is a cluster of capillaries which has many number of nephrons. Like in the heart, from the heart when the blood goes, so lungs will act as a filtration unit. But same way, in the case of excretion, the filtration unit will be the nephrons, which is filled with many number of capillaries are there. So these all the capillaries are joined together. Here the blood, the nitrogen waste come from this renal artery. From here it will come. Okay. So from here it comes. This is called Bowman's capsule. It is a cup-like structure. Where it contains glomerular tubules are there. Okay, so these tubules, their work is nothing, they will capture many waste material, and actually here what happens, there the place of reabsorption take place. So required food material which has come from our body in the form of nitrogen waste, such as glucose, sucrose, amino acid, minerals, salts, and even water also has come. So these all are reabsorbed, means it is absorbed, and whatever the required material is required for our body, that is sent back, and again it is filtered. So in this capillaries there are many millions of what? Nephrons. So these nephrons will act as the main filtering unit, where their work is to filter. Okay, here it comes, here it will filter. This is a process, and it goes to other parts. Again, from through this branch it will come out. Again, it is sent to one unit called collecting unit, where actually what happens, this is the upper part, collecting unit. All the waste is collected, which is in the form of urine, and is sent to the collecting unit, and that passes to what? To ureter, which are perfected to ureter. From ureter, they go to the urinary bladder, which is a muscular structure where there is this. It can be expanded because it has elastic muscles. It will expand it, and due to pressure also, when it get expands, so generally it go, human beings will go for urination and all. So in this way, there are many millions and billions of nephrons, which are filtering units of the nitrogen waste present in the body, and they are present in the kidneys. So this is a case of normal human being. If there are some diseases, or we could generally call disorder. So I think you know very well, there is sometimes kidney failure. But actually, what is kidney failure? Means kidney is unable to filter the nitrogenous waste. Means it has lost its capacity to respond towards the removal of nitrogen waste, because of sometimes there is sometimes injury takes place. Okay, sometimes overeating, okay, and over drinking of food, unlimited eating of food, that all may lead, okay, and even less quantity of food, less quantity of water supply to the body will also lead to the sometimes kidney problem. So that is why we call renal, actually we call renal diseases, generally called renal disease, renal is related to the kidney only. Okay, so these all are many important kidney diseases are there, and because nitrogen waste cannot be thrown out, so that will get accumulated in the body, that becomes a poison, sometimes the person may die also. There may be many deaths because of due to the renal failure. There is a technical term or which is disorder of kidney called renal failure. So when a kidney fails to filter the product, so accumulation of waste product takes place in the body, and due to this accumulation of waste product, and there is no path of removal. Sometimes there is blockage of water, urinary bladder also, sometimes there is blockage because the urinary bladder will block. It blocks, the nitrogen waste cannot come here because it is already blocked, and sometimes person may not be able to pass urine also. So many difficulties are there. Because of that, drinking water is a must for kidney working, and even urinary bladder and urethra system, because when the kidney filters, it will filter all the things. What are the nitrogen waste, urea, uric acid, whatever things are there, all will be filtered. But there is reabsorption, means whatever the required material is there, it will send back. Remaining, it is thrown out in the form of urine. Okay. So in case of the patients whose kidney are failed to work, there we are following artificial dialysis, a technique of artificial dialysis. So the same functioning of this kidney is done by that machine which is called artificial dialysis. Okay, I think it's simple. I draw one simple diagram. This is from artery. This is from veins. Okay, so there is one big absorbing unit will be there. There is a big, we call selective absorption techniques or osmotic absorption techniques. Osmosis techniques means there is a layer where the filtered whatever the waste is there, it is filtered, and again it is collected and it is sent back to the person who is undergoing dialysis. And this dialysis is very very costly technique, because once a person goes for dialysis, nearly he has to spend 10 lakh rupees or 5 lakh rupees for one dialysis. So it is very costlier. So due to that, awareness is very simple. People should be aware of drinking more water, using more water. And nowadays, techniques have come where we are able to follow the simple lifestyles, and you are able to get rid of kidney diseases, kidney disorders. And to keep these fresh kidneys as very normal, simple and all, so we should give always simple and normal food. Okay, this is how dialysis machine work. Once you go through textbook, once you will be little clear. So please read textbook whenever it is taught something here, so that will be how, if you have any doubts, you can we again clarify in some other session. Okay, now this is how the kidney dialysis, artificial dialysis take place. And coming to excretion in plants, you know very well. We as human beings or animals, they have excretory parts, excretory organs, where they are able to excrete different nitrogen waste. But in the case of plants, their plants also will excrete. Actually, the oxygen their main excretory product is oxygen only, because they have to remove the oxygen. So due to photosynthesis or due to other processes, there may be some accumulation of oxygen that should be removed. Sometimes what happens, these all plants, they do not have particular excretory organs are not there. Okay, sometimes what happens if the more waste is accumulated in the plants also, they are removed in the form of, they go and store in the form of storage in the vacuole. And for some days, they will fall, they will come and join, they will be with the leaves and the falling of leaves take place. So that is nothing. When the leaf fall in some plants, that shows that there is waste product removed, means excretion is done there. Okay, in some plants which are developed, which are little older, they have in the like, you know, outer part of the stem we see some resins and gums. There is the excretory product in the form of resins and gums. So that is one way of getting rid of the waste from the plants. And even xylem will be also there, which is supplying water from all parts. So through the, see, mainly your transpiration takes place, I know. Transpiration takes place from that, by the help of transpiration, the liquid waste which goes in the form of oxygen is there. But still, many quantity if waste is removed, present there, there is there.